Today, I'd like to highlight a catalog with all the Tinkercad shapes, so let's get cracking. I'm going to start at my website, HLModTech.com. Of course, I've got a page dedicated to Tinkercad, all sorts of amazing categories, and then below that, you got the day one favorites, the useful starters, and the Tinkercad essentials. Today, I want to highlight the Tinkercad Shape Catalog. When you click on this, you get to copy the document. That means that you will have your very own copy of the project. After a moment it launches, notice it says Copy of Shape Catalog. That means you can click on these and adjust them as much as you want. If you've never used Tinkercad, these are the basic shapes. They are what we see every day, but this one is usually hidden. I went in and hit Show More until we could see them all, and bang, you can now see all the shapes, and you've got the words right here if you ever wanted to search for one. If you look down at the bottom of this spreadsheet, we've got the labels for all the other pieces. Notice when you first click on it, you're only going to see the first chunk of these. I clicked the View More, View More, View More until we could see them all, and now you have got the ability to see all the possible shapes in an instant. Now, of course, for designers, this can be an awesome technique to see the cool things you can use. Also, for teachers, it is a good way to see that if somebody turns in a cow or this little character, they really did not do any work. They were just dragging shapes into Tinkercad and putting them in their projects. You'll notice some tabs do not have many projects. You'll notice others have tons of them. This structures and scenery is one of my favorites, just because of all the cool things you can add. If you're making houses, there are windows, there are doors, fences. You can make your projects look absolutely fantastic in just a little bit of time. So right now I'm going to try and add a beach chair and a spire to a Tinkercad project. This, of course, is Tinkercad.com. I always choose Sign In with Google. When we want to make a brand new design, we click right here and choose 3D Design. This is where you name it. I'm just going to call this Fun. And I'm going to add the word Catalog because it's about the catalog. When we click down here, these are the shapes. Remember the basic shapes? There are the more shapes. That is the diamond once again. You can hover over these and read the names, but also we've now got them in the spreadsheet. Real quickly, when you click back here, your project is instantly saved. This is what they look like. They are private. Before we end, I'll show you how to make these public as well. I'm going to click Tinker this, though, and I'm going to go to Search. And remember I said I wanted to find the Gothic Spire. First, I'm going to just type Spire, and bang, there it is. Now, sometimes you'll have to type both words. Just letting you know that. I'm going to click on this and notice right now it runs into that shape. If I hit C for cruising, I can grab that dot and cruise it on top of the shape. So that's just one fun skill with Tinkercad. I'm not going to teach you everything about Tinkercad today, but if you want to see my day one playlist, I will put a link to it and the bit.ly right up here. Now I'm going to quickly back up. And I'm going to switch to a different category. Remember I said I wanted to use structures and scenery. This is all you see in the basic shape. I once again went through and clicked on these so we could get to all of them. And there is the beach chair. Now the beach chair is crazy big compared to this part. So I'll show you this skill real quick. You can shift squeeze to scale many shapes down to the size you want. So now, friends, I'm going to challenge you, make your own fun project with as many crazy things as you can. Just explore, find parts. You can look for them in the catalog, or you can just look for them on your own. And then when you have made something you're proud of, click back here on the Tinkercad workspace, click up here on the gear, and change its properties. Fill it in with whatever you want. Of course, mine says tutorial coming soon. I've also added all kinds of information for how you can track me down if you'd like to, and how you can see projects shared every day. I've also added tags. Remember, if you add the tag HLMT23, I check that tag out every day, and I will give you reactions as long as you remember to make your design public. You can set it so nobody can mess with it by doing attribution no derivatives. This just makes it so users can see it, or you can set it to share alike so they can open it and modify and play with your creation. Once you hit save changes, your project will be shared to the gallery. When you click on the gallery, the first thing you see are all the amazing staff picks. Of course, if you look through them, there are tons of amazing designs. This one is actually a real car created by Camilo. You really need to take a moment to check out his profile by clicking here. Of course, if you look far enough, you'll probably find one of my designs. Make sure you check the information beside it. There are lots of other cool things shared as well, including tutorials. Don't forget also, reactions are always appreciated. Finally, though, I wanted to highlight that if you shut off staff picks, you will be able to see all the users' designs. I always like to make the grid large and then check out all the fantastics created by users. CMF, that is absolutely fantastic. Here's another fun one right here. Love to check these out. Makes my day to give reactions. You just never know whose day you might be making. That's awesome. And of course, if we look right over here, and bang, there is my fun project. One other highlight, if you hit view in 3D, you can actually check out the creations from every angle. How cool is that? If you use the search tool and type HLMT23, you can check these every day. There are so many fantastic designs. And of course, I will always check them and give them reactions. Always makes my day to see the cool stuff. Of course, even more so when users like Semirath actually use my tutorials and make them epic. That's fantastic. Real quickly, highlighting the awesome How Can You Be Kind by Kelichu, the coding critic. That is fantastic. And check out the sweet Shelby GT500 Nightmare. Once again, you can always hit view in 3D, and if you're patient, you can watch it load and check it out from every angle. How cool is that? Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.